Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Salam sejahtera dan salam Unimas kesayang. Yang berhormat Datuk Gerawat Gala, Deputy Speaker pada Sarawak State Legislative Assembly and the State Assemblyman for Mulu. Yang bahagia Profesor Dr. Wan Hashimun Ibrahim, Deputy Vice Chancellor Research and Innovation. Yang bahagia Profesor Dr. Ahmad Hatta Rasid, Deputy Vice Chancellor Academic and International. Yang bahagia Profesor Dr. Kamarudin Kana, Deputy Vice Chancellor Student Affairs and Alumni. Yang bahagia Profesor Dr. Muhammad Fadil Abdul Rahman, Assistant Vice Chancellor Leadership and Development. Unimas Management, Deans, Directors and Colleagues in Unimas, sponsors and key partners of the eBorneo Knowledge Fair, distinguished guests, media members and especially to our community members and all participants. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you to the 8th eBorneo Knowledge Fair 2021 or EBKF 8. I'm delighted to see so many familiar faces here with us today. And indeed, I'm honored to welcome new members to this community, especially those joining us from as far as the United Kingdom, the United States of America, Hong Kong, New Zealand, Brazil, Mozambique, and Canada. And also those from our own state of Sarawak and from the rest of Malaysia. The growing number of participants across many more sites this year is testament to the fact that EBKF 8 is indeed crossing boundaries and extending its reach and impact, particularly with its ongoing initiatives to address important issues regarding Indigenous communities and ICTs. Ladies and gentlemen, this year, for the first time ever, we are brought together virtually to participate yet again in this meaningful and significant event, EBKF 8. Since the pandemic started, we have witnessed people all over the world going through tremendous change, be it professionally or personally. We now have to adapt to new norms, and one key difference is the need to conduct events and meetings through virtual platform. Interestingly enough, what seemed to be a distant vision of the future just 2 years ago has now become a reality for us all. And I am amazed at our resilience and capabilities of so many of us here today to overcome these trials. I am indeed happy to note that the team from Unimas has risen to the challenge to make virtual conference management as our forte by this pioneering feat in raising the level of EBKF 8 to become truly the first of its kind, co-design, developmental multi-conference. The uniqueness of this offering is mainly due to the transdisciplinary research that we have in Unimas, powered by research fellows who come from all faculties and institutes in the university. Indeed, these are interesting and exciting times, especially as we have risen to the challenge and embraced these changes, both within the university as well as in the way we are conducting our close partnership with our researchers and community members and society as a whole. We are very proud to be part of this innovative change, especially when we are working tirelessly together towards creating inclusive opportunities for everyone, especially with Indigenous communities. Inclusiveness has always been an agenda that EBKF has stood for, and by bringing all of us here together on a digital platform highlights the fact that we are indeed moving in the right direction. In my previous encounter with the communities of Bakalalan and Krayan Indo in Indonesia during EBKF 7, I have become fully appreciative of its unique participatory model. Ladies and gentlemen, as the premier public university in Sarawak, Unimas is dedicated towards contributing back towards society. Unimas has long embedded this philosophy in its approach to knowledge because we have belief in the value of working towards fostering close relationship with multicultural, disparate and diverse communities. UNIMAS aims to continue working with helping communities throughout Sarawak. And this is evident in many projects that we have conducted, managed, led and collaborated with over the past 20 years. UNIMAS through research institutes, such as the Institute of Social Informatics and Technological Innovation, or ICT, has worked with several indigenous communities throughout Malaysia, such as in Pahang and Kelantan in West Malaysia, Buayan and Larapan in Sabah, and also in the Baram and Lawas, including such areas as Bario, Long Lamai and Baklalan in Sarawak. I am very pleased to see that the close bond between UNIMAS and these communities has continued to grow over the years, leading us to where we stand today at the 8th E-Borneo Knowledge Fair. It is through close collaborations with the local indigenous communities like this that the world can bear witness to the importance of partnering researchers with relevant communities to bridge the gap between theoretical understanding and issues in the real world. This year, I am proud that EBKF has extended its reach beyond what was initially imagined, and we are reaching out and creating value for indigenous communities through the various collaborations and partnerships that we have fostered with our different stakeholders, especially as we involve more people on international scale. We have fully benefited from the virtual experience and the powers of boundaryless interactions and dialogues. Ladies and gentlemen, the EBKF is a unique conference which looks at promoting research that innovates with technologies in order to address the challenges and opportunities that remote and isolated indigenous communities face. It is also a platform to bring together various stakeholders, the teams from the government, the industry, academia, to address issues together with the communities, to listen to their voices as they express their thoughts, beliefs, opinions, and experience on various issues pertinent to community development in the 21st century perspective. In this year's conference, we have Sarawak Multimedia Authority supporting as technology partner, and this brings for us the linkages to 49 digital community centers throughout the state. As a result, EBKF8 has turned out to be a Sarawakian homegrown model of a global development conference that is scalable and at the same time bridges the digital divide by its translational and transformational research elements. Our partnership with the State Modernization Unit is ongoing, and this year we have established a formal link with Miri City Council. We have become a key collaborator. We particularly acknowledge the contribution and continued support of Sarawak Energy in sponsoring the event. The Academy Science Malaysia has this year joined us as a partner, particularly ahead of the launch of the Sarawak chapter later this year. Thank you all for this wonderful contribution. 2 years ago, we took EBKF one step further as we connected with local communities from across the border in Krayan for the first time. This was indeed an exciting achievement for all of us, especially as this is indicative of how EBKF is instrumental in meeting, discussing and deliberating on relevant solutions to challenges faced by the community. This year, we are spreading the wings of EBKF further as we connect with wider community all around the globe through this virtual platform. And I believe that we are well on our way towards becoming a discourse channel that is referred to and acknowledged the world over. I would like to extend my greatest appreciation to our academic partners from Cornell University, University of Alberta, Bournemouth University, University of Rio, and University College of Technology Sarawak. And our industry partners from Sarawak Energy Berhad and Conscious Ventures, our government agency partners from the State Modernization Unit and Miri Council, our community linkage partners from Rurum Kelabit Sarawak, Formadat, Malaysia Trees Innovation Association, and the Worldwide Fund for Nature, as well as our international collaborators from Asia Pacific Partnership for Responsible Rural Tourism and the UNESCO Chair for ICT4D-led Consortium, Digital Environment System Coalition, for taking the time and greatly contributing towards the success of EBKF8. I am sure that all the representatives from our partners across the board, together with members from the various indigenous communities from Barrio, Long Tanit, Long Lamai, Bakalalan, Long Bawan, and Long Pasir, as well as the Orang Asli sites of Pos Gop, Pos Balar, Pos Sindurut, and Pos Lenjang in Peninsular Malaysia, are all gathered to collaborate and have dialogues on different areas of interest to the indigenous community, particularly on matters pertaining to ICTs and indigenous development, cross-border biodiversity conservation and management, community-based ecotourism, preservation of cultural heritage with ICTs, and indigenizing ICT4D, to name a few. I have to especially mention Worldwide Fund for Nature, WWF, and FOMADAT for jointly organizing and enriching this conference with a diverse and rich community linkages that has made the conference what it is today. The conference has proven in this way to be truly co-designed with the community and inclusive. Ladies and gentlemen, may I take this opportunity to congratulate the organizing team from UNIMAS, the Institute of Social Informatics and Technological Innovation, ICT, together with Institute of Borneo Studies, IBS, supported by UNIMAS Sustainability Center, UNIMAS Leadership Center, UNIMAS Global, and all supporting faculties and institutes. Congratulations for the pioneering spirit and enterprising effort. To conclude, I would like to wish all the participants of EBKF8 a valuable deliberation and hope that your time here at the Knowledge Fair will be very productive for you in both your professional and personal growth. Thank you. Wabillahi taufiq wal hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.